Renata, we're live. And we are live. And we're coming in at the last second here. Renata, you want to do the honors, please?
Yes. Hey, guys. Good evening. Welcome to Brazil, Brazil with Renata Lopez. And today we go show the Vidigal favela and talk a little bit about it. I hope everybody like, everybody enjoy.
Okay. Well, I want to welcome everybody to the show. This is our Thursday show. As you know, we go hard every Monday and Thursday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And we try to bring you all the information we can about Rio, Brazil. Rio right now, but eventually all of Brazil. And it's Renata's job to show you guys what you can come down to Rio and do, whether it's very touristy things or some of the off the beaten path type places you can go and things you can see. So, boa noite, Marcus, Xavier, how you doing? Welcome everybody in the room. So today we're going to Vidigal again. This is the second time you're going there on our, is it the second time or third? Third, right? You went for the trail and you went to Rocinha. And today you're going to
Vidigal.
What's the place called that you're going to? Or you just, in general, you're just going to Vidigal?
Vidigal.
Okay. Okay. So, Vidigal is a favela in Rio. It's considered one of the safe favelas, meaning that it's open for tourists. They welcome tourists to come in and check out the different places. Why it's famous is it has a very beautiful view. Where it's located, on the side of the mountain, you look out over the land, the beach, the ocean, and it's a great place to have this type of club, restaurant, live venue. And we're gonna check it out. We're just gonna wait for some more people to get in here. But what are we doing for Monday's show? We always try to tell you what's coming up. So what do you got coming up?
On the Monday show, I have the Santa Teresa place.
Santa Teresa.
Yes. Where's this train? You know, the train? It's all the...
Oh, yeah.
And the train, it's passing Lapa. People, they go in the train to see the city. Some tourists, they stay in this place and they say they like it.
This is the place that's close to the Celeron stairs, right?
Like it's right.
Right there?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, cool. Cool, yeah. I've never been there. I've seen pictures of it. It has like streetcars. It kind of reminds me like how they have in San Francisco.
Right.
Yeah. Chris King asks, what are we drinking today? Oh, you brought it home with you. So you got that in Vidigal. And you're drinking a caipirinha.
Yes, caipirinha.
Saúde.
Saúde.
Okay. All right. Do you want to get started with the video? You want to wait a little bit? Okay, let's talk about where it's. Well, maybe I should wait because we do have questions that you want to answer. When we want to watch the video first, right?
Right.
Yeah. Or you want to start answering the questions first?
Yes, it's good if we start to answer.
Okay, we can do some of the questions. Maybe not all of them, but
Many people, they want to know, where is it, the favela Vidigal?
Okay, let me get to the question. I'm pulling them up. Hold on. All right. What is the name of the favela?
Vidigal.
Vidigal. And where is it located?
That's the Vidigal place. It stay between Leblon and São Conrado.
Or Leblon and Ipanema, right?
Leblon, and because Leblon, it's passed to Ipanema. Then after Leblon, it's Vidigal place.
After Leblon, okay.
And then after Leblon, it's São Conrado. So Vidigal place, it's between Ipanema, Leblon, and São Conrado. But it's Leblon. It's Vidigal, the place, the name of the place.
Okay. And it's before Barra, the Tijuca. So there it is right there, guys. Yeah. Okay. How long does it take to get from like Copacabana to Leblon for people that come? Because most people that visit Rio for the first time anyways go to Copa or Ipanema. How long does it take?
Yeah, it takes like 16, 20 minutes maximum.
Okay, that's not bad.
It's 60 minutes. It's the traffic, it's open. You know, the Uber go very easy. And
16 minutes.
Yeah, but if it's a little bit traffic, then it take like 20 minutes to go there.
Okay.
With Uber. Yeah, sometimes it's hard to find Uber to go there. Some they accept it, but it's a little bit looking for. You know, because when the Uber or the taxi, you say you want to go into Vidigal, they thinking you want to take the Uber or the taxi to go all the way up inside the favela.
So what do you have to tell them? Because, yeah, no taxi wants to go up in the favela. They're going to have problems, right?
No, they don't going to have problems. They don't want to go up because sometimes it's forced a lot to the car, you know, and it's a lot of traffic inside the favela. Cars and motorcycles go up and down, you know, they prefer to stay there under in the beginning, in the entry for the favela.
So what would go ahead.
And then you just need to go find your way to go up there by yourself.
So what would you tell the taxi for people that are in, say, Copa and they want to go to Vidigal? What would you tell the taxi? Take me to the bottom of Vidigal? Is there a certain place that you say?
Yeah, geez, an entry.
Okay, so take me to the entry of Vidigal.
Okay. Right.
So, okay, so basically Vidigal is on this side of this mountain. And the easiest way to get around there is to jump on a motor taxi and they can scoot you up there.
Right.
It is a favela, so it is a protected area, as in that they protect that area. So you can't just freely walk around anywhere you want. Let's continue with the questions, and I think we're going to get to some of that. Okay, yeah. Like, what's the best way to get there? So taxi to the entry. And then at the entry?
Yeah, then you go to the entry. And then you ask them for the taxi take you or the Uber. You know, they take you, normally they take you only to the entry. And then when you are in the entry, you need to take the moto taxi or also get a van to go all the way up there. Because it's not everybody want to take the moto. Some say, have other way. Yes, have other way. You can get a van to go all the way up there.
So, yeah, they have a van that it's almost like a little bus. you know, and you can jump in that van at the bottom, at the entry, and it'll take you up wherever you want to go in the favela. And then they have the motorcycle taxis. So that's the two ways to get up there. Okay. So if somebody is going to Vidigal that doesn't really know Vidigal, where do they go? Where should they go? What should they be looking for? They want the favela experience. They want to go somewhere cool. Where are they going?
Yeah, they have the trail, you know, Morro dos Irmãos, like the two brothers.
Mm-hmm. That's what you guys did before, right?
Yes.
If you look back near the, I think our first episode was Renata and her friend Estela going to Vidigal and doing the trail. That was like a 45-minute hike up the mountain to the top. Beautiful view up there, but it's a 45-minute hike. So if you like the exercise, if you're that guy, then you'll enjoy it. Go ahead. So the trail, what else?
Have a Bar da Laje. It's a very popular bar in restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
Always the price when I'm there all the time, when I ask and the price, it's about 80 reais most of the time to Bar da Laje. That's like more fashion.
Okay.
And have other ones, have Alto do Mirante and Mirante do Arvão. That's where I go most of the time.
Okay.
Thanks.
So there's three places basically that are the popular places to go. Three bars. Is there a lot of little bars, or is those the main?
Yeah, it's a lot of little bars there. You can stop. You can drink. I saw some tourists when I come up or down. They sit in the bars and a small restaurant around there. Have everything inside there: pharmacy, market.
So, are all the bars safe to go to? Or
yes, yeah? Yes.
Okay, that's cool. That's cool. And you definitely, you'll see in the video that to get to where Renata went, it's a good little drive up. I mean, it took what, about 10 minutes?
Yes.
But it's 10 minutes on a pretty steep hill. So you don't want to try to walk. Chester says, Renata y Dennis, tudo bem, sing,
esh, yes. Bang. Thank you.
Bang. Okay. Let's start the video, I guess. We've got some people in here. You ready to go?
Yes. All ready. Right. Can't wait to watch the video.
Here we go. This is Renata's journey to Favela do Vidigal.
Hey, guys. Welcome to Brazil with Renata Lopes. And today I'm going to show you guys the favela from Vidigal and how you can do for going to the Bar da Laje, Bar do Arvão, Alto do Mirante. Have so many nice places here in this favela for you guys go enjoy the drinks, the view, the nighttime club. It's really nice. It's safe area. So now I'm going to show you guys two ways to go all the way up there. Renata, it's okay. I just go there walking. Yes, you can walk in inside the favelas. It's no problem, but you stay in the main street, not going to inside the street where you don't know the area exactly. Because sometimes you just walk in and the house, it's so tight, small, one next to the other one. Maybe one misstep, you are inside somebody's house because you don't know how to walk in. So I suggest just stay in the main street. It's many bars, restaurants. So just come here in this place and enjoy. Now come with me. Let me show you guys the options to go up. You can go with motorcycle or also you can take a van. So let's come with me.
Thank you.
Here, they sell pastel and they sell caldo de cana, the sugar cane. I don't know how to say exactly in English, but here people, they sit, they eat the pastel. It's delicious.
Sugar cane.
Delicious. With meat, cheese, chicken, have many different types. Really good. And here what you can guys see, it's the motorcycles to go up there to Bar da Laje, Mirante do Arvrão, and many, many places up there. So here it's very close to the entry. You just need to take one moto. If you guys see it, it's a line because it's about time. That's the time for this guy, so he pick up you and go up. It's not just you come and pick up one. It's a line for motorcycles to go up there. So come with me, see the second options. Here, if you turn a little bit, here it's the vans. I don't want to take a motorcycle, so just go in a van. It's people's, they wait. The van, now it sit here because need to wait for fill the van for go up. So if have only one person, then they have to wait for four more, maybe five to the van leaving. So it's also very good, very safely. And they take you all the way up where you want to stay. You just need to let the guy exactly where you go. I go into Bar da Laje, I go into this place or that, and they take you. Come with me. So guys, now what I have to say, the good time for come, it's after 12, you know, 12 a.m. That's the good time for come because the bars, the restaurants, they are open that time. So not come like 9, 8, 10, because then most of the place is closed. So it's better come like 12 or 11:30. Then you see the commerces, the storage is open. So let's go because I can't wait. I can't wait to go there, show you guys the bars, the restaurants. Yes, the guy now, he's just explained me. Here it's always, all the time have a van here where you can go up. And when you are there, you go into the restaurant, to the bar, wherever where you go, always have also van up there wait for you, you know, to come down, to bring you down. And it costs 10 reais to go and 10 reais for back. Now it's just one van. See, everybody's leaving out. This one, it's already full packet. Everybody going to the bar do Avrão, Mirante. They going to the bar, the lodging. Very nice. Look the line. There are lots of motorcycles. Hey guys, now I'm here with Thiago. Barcelone
e Marcos,
vocês podem falar.
Pessoal, trabalho aqui na comunidade do Vidigal, é um lugar muito bom, tem muita gente de fora que vem aqui conhecer o nosso visual, conhecer o Mirante do Abrão, Padalagem. Recomendo a vocês que apareçam aqui para vocês curtir um pouco as praias, pegar um pouco também do visual e vão ser bem recebidos e vai ser bem-vindos aqui na comunidade, tá?
Yeah, he say, guys, come to the Vidigal. It's very good vibe in Bar da Laje, Mirante, all the things is really good. He's working in a van now, so you guys can come, can talk to him, take me up, and he's do it. That's his job. Is she also working, the kid also, everybody working here. So just come to Vidigal and enjoy.
I wanted to show most of the trip, sorry to interrupt, because I want people to know that you cannot walk up the hill. So it's because some people say, I'll just walk. No, it's a good steep walk, and it's a good long walk.
Now we are all the way up here. That's where you guys supposed to be stopped when you guys come with the motorcycles. That's where they bring you. You stop here and then after go here to Bar da Laje, Mirante do Arvrão, the place you guys want to go.
Hold on, I want to pause for a second. I just saw a comment in there. Hold on, Renata, sorry. Okay, Marcus, he said, many people in favelas prefer that you call them comunidades because it doesn't have the negative connotations. Yeah, I know before, Renata, you told me that you didn't like when calling it favelas because there's some negativity to it, but...
Yes, but they say favelas sometimes. Yeah, when I'm here, talk with the guy downstairs, down there in the entry, you know, he say, oh, that's good. You bring the thing for the favela. And I'm the one, when I talk with him, I say community. He's the one say favela,
mm-hmm.
You know. So, and most... the tourists and the guys, they understand, they say favela. I want to go to the favela.
Yeah.
So it's, to me, it's not sounds too aggressive. Some people, they say that, oh, it's not nice, it's not good. But it's really, for most people, yes, it's not bottle, you know, because that's what most the French people, they talk. That's how they know. Yeah. They don't say community. They don't know favela about community. They just say favela.
Yeah, I think guys that go to Brazil, that they want that experience. Oh, let me go to the favela. They're not thinking, let me go to a community. They want to know where they're going, and that's just kind of the name that's been it's stigmatized to these areas. So I think it's more about the context and the way you use it. Just be respectful as much as you can, and yeah. I think for the most part, these communities are taking that negativity and turning it around into something positive. They're using that name and using it for a positive purpose to help grow the community and bring money into the community. So that's good. That's good. They just, you know, use that negative and market it and make it nice. Okay, let's keep going.
Yeah. Okay, now we go in because now I'm going to show you guys Mirante do Arvrão. Come with me, let's go. Valeu, obrigado. So now what you have to do after get off the motorcycle, just walk in. It's safe, don't worry, it's not a problem at all. Okay guys, after 1-2 minutes walking, we are here. That's the van where take you guys all the time up and down when you want to come to this place. Here it's Mirante do Arvrão. The other side, it's a Bar da Laje. I want to go Mirante do Arvrão. They are almost the same thing. The difference is one place, it's more big, the other one. I mean, this Mirante do Arvrão, it's like three floor floors. Bar da Laje also good, nice, modern. And have other ones also here. You know, you just need to pick up one, which one you like and just go for, because the view, that's the same. So come with me. Okay guys, now I have to pay because Saturday, Sunday, when it have events, some music, concert, then you're supposed to be paid the entry. And now the entry it's cost 50 reais. Sometimes it's cost 80, sometimes depends where you go, also the entry it's different price. But today it's 50 reais the entry. So come with me.
Live your life within the moment, moment. And don't go wait until the morning, morning. You never know when it is over, over. All that I know is we'll get older, older. So let us dance this night away. It's getting thicker. But get away from the drinks and chatter. Haven't said a word, but it doesn't matter. Feel the air getting thinner. Standing in a blurry dream. No one else can see us. Live your life within the moment, moment. And don't go away.
They sell that.
Feel the air get thinner. I'm standing in a blurry dream. No one else can see us. So let us dance this night away.
Have some drink, enjoy the view. Cheers! I want two! I want two! I want one caipirinha.
Sorry, my English is so okay.
All right. He's speaking English so.
Okay, I want to pause it for 1 second. Chris King with the $5 super chat. Thank you, brother. Thank you for support. He says, King Ben Sao. Yes, what a blessing. Okay.
Thank you very much.
What else? Yes, Chester, roughly $20 USD. No, it's less than. You said 80, right? Plus the ride up. Yeah, about 20 bucks. And then your drinks. Okay. Hanata, anything you want to say before we continue?
No. Let's go.
Okay, let's go. Thanks again, Chris. You're the man.
What is your name?
Renata.
My name is Saulo.
His name is Saulo. And he's going to make one caipirinha for us. Limão. 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 Crush, crush, crush. Crush, crush, crush. Look. Guys, it costs 27 reais for the caipirinha. Good price. Good, good.
Cheers, Renata.
Cheers. Again. Okay, guys. Okay, guys, the glass, it's cost 16 reais, and the caipirinha, 27. Really nice glass. I love it. Oh, what's that? Very good. Obrigada, hein? Very good, guys. Very good. Look at the view. Let me stay this side.
It's a beautiful view. What is that view worth? That's $1 million view there, guys. JB with the $9.99 super chat. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Yes, guys, buy Hinata a drink, man. You know, she's out there. You see, she's working it. All right, let's continue.
Buy Hinata a drink.
Right. Oh, let me see what he said. He says, good content, guys. So, yes, much appreciated. And somebody said earlier they love the production and the editing and stuff. I want to say I didn't film this. I'm not in Rio right now. So I want to thank Bianca. That's Renata's cousin that's out there with the camera. And yeah, when I was there, I kind of showed Renata and I showed them how to use the camera and what to do. And we're always going back and forth with critiques and, oh, do this, do this, do this. But they're doing a fantastic job out there. So I appreciate it. And I'm in Orlando right now. I just get the footage and I edit it and put it together. But it's the work of a team. It's not just me. It's a team effort. So yeah, let's keep going.
Really good. You know, the adrenaline when you take the motorcycle to come off. You know, everything is so nice. Good, very good. I love it. And now, you know, we're going to the other floor, to the third floor, because I want to enjoy the live music and you guys stay and come with me.
Mas é a primeira vez que você vai no pagode e escuta a música sem nada. A pessoa pode escutar aquela música, vai mandar lá no Instagram e eu vou atender. Até quando eu não souber, eu vou cantar. Ensaiei meu samba o ano inteiro. Com preço de todo mundo.
The food smells very good. I smell the
também, mas quando eu não puder brisar mais na beleza, deixe o seu bicho mais novo, o meu pedido final, antes de me despedir, deixe o seu bicho mais novo. O samba morrer, o povo foi feito de samba, que samba muito, bora do meu coração, o tempo não passa pra gente viver, o ano vai brincar, fumacinha do surrão, teu corpo é o barco, não te quero navegar, e no seu modo de vida.
We have a question from Chris. Is she still in the favela? $1 million view in the favela. Yeah. A lot of the favelas, well, I don't know. I haven't been to a lot of favelas, but you always see those favelas on the side of those mountains. They got the best view. It's really weird that the poorest places are in these places that have these beautiful views. I think it's kind of strange. Yeah, let's keep going. Renato, what night was this? What was it? A Saturday? Was it a weekend?
When was Saturday? It?
Saturday night. And you went early, right? This is pretty early. I noticed.
Yes. Yeah. More late. It's more people come there.
Yeah. You suggested earlier in the video that people should go there after, like, around midnight.
Not midnight. I say 12, but in the daytime. I say not come early before 12 because everything is closed. The bars, the restaurants.
Okay. That's what I was wondering why. Okay.
So if it's in the daytime, people want to go there, you know, just go after 12 because then the bars and the restaurants it's open 12.
Okay, cool. And they have good food at these places, guys. Very good food. Do they have a buffet like the other place here?
Buffet?
Yeah, the other place that you went to. Had a buffet.
No, that's a Rocinha.
Okay. Okay.
And a Rocinha also don't have buffet all the time. You know, it depends on the event. Mm. The day we are there, that's have the buffet for feijoada buffet. But it's not me. It's there all the time, and they have buffet all the time.
Okay.
Era el oficial, baby, no remix, yeah. Todas tus amigas, Jamie's me girl. Todos necesitamos algún día ese feeling, yeah. Ay, sonríe tú, pero el feliz soy yo. Este porque me bautice. Entre la luna y el sol, pegado siento calor, yeah, yeah. Como una historia pa' que me deslice. Y el deslizado soy yo, como haciendo el amor, yeah, yeah. Es que estoy puesto pa' ti, en la cama va fluido, eh. Lo que yo siento por ti, lo que tú sientes por mi bebé. Es que estoy puesto pa' ti, en la cama va fluido, eh. Lo que yo siento por ti, lo que tú sientes por mí. Pega en la casa como FedEx. Lo que tú sientes por mí, por mí, yeah.
Y aí, galera! Vocês estão prontos? Eu não ouvi! Vocês estão prontos? Então vamos lá!
to all the guys. So take this love and try to make it new. You can't fight it when it feels so true. You drive me crazy like no one else. The final moment before I lose myself. And it's no use working 9 to 5. If you want more than to stay alive, so come on over, we can make it through. Take my hand, I know just what to do. On the beat, keep dancing through the night. Stay up until the morning. Stay up until the morning
Subscribe, leave comments, and follow me on Instagram.
Okay, there you have it, guys. That was exciting. I want to go to that place.
Yes, it's really, really good. You know, especially when the kids start singing the show. Oh my God, it's a really big show.
It looked hype. Somebody put a message. Let me put it up. Chris says, some of it sounds like something out of Africa, and then some of it sounds like music from New Orleans. It all comes back to Africa, man. You know that. All that drum sounds, man. It's hype. Love it. Love it. Let's get back to some of these questions.
Yes, it's really, really good. The show with the kids, oh my God, it's huge. It's big show, fantastic, you know, incredible. I really love it. It's really nice.
Okay. All right. Number 6, is it safe? You kind of answered that already.
Yes, it is safe. You know, this place before, the Vidigal before, it's not area where the tourists can go in, you know, but then some tourists start to come, and then the people from there, they discussions, they talk about it, because some tourists start come to this place, and then they start to make money. And then also, it's, I don't know in English, Pacific. This community start to be Pacific. Up there, it's have the police office, you understand?
Oh, okay.
So they some agree, have some agree, and then it's... now it's all together, you know, it's all, everything's good. I don't know if I'm explained correct.
They brokered peace, guys. So it's cool because they have an actual police station in the favela, and they keep the community safe. They all work together to keep it safe. But do remember where you are and be respectful. And
yeah.
Also, what you mentioned before about not going, just staying on the main road and not going into these little side streets because you don't know where you're going to end up.
Yeah.
You want to say more about that?
Yeah, that's what I say. It's safe, you know. That's why I recommend you guys, if you guys want to go into some favela in Rio, just go into that one. I don't know about Rocinha. I think Rocinha more or less the same. I'm not going a lot to Rocinha. I just been there in Rocinha one time. So I don't know compared to this, because Rocinha, it's much more big, huge. That's one's the big favelas. So I don't know there how the thing is working. But this one, I'm more guaranteed safe.
Okay. All right, let me get to the next question here. Well, what do you think about this favela? You kind of already said it. This is the one you recommend above all the other favelas in Rio. This is the one you say to go to.
Yes. Rocinha also, you know, but I only been in Rocinha one time, so I don't have much things to say about Rocinha, but I think it's the same rules for this one. It's the same in Rocinha. You possible walk in the main street, just take the motorcycle, going to Mirante da Rocinha. I don't know what Rocinhas have more there, up there. Same in Vidigal. Vidigal, I know three places already. You can go to enjoy the music, you know, live music, to dance and to drink. It's more and more people, they come in the nighttime than the daytime. What I see it, you know, it's a lot of people, they come there for enjoy the night. So it's not dangerous, you guys can see, because some people, they thinking the danger is it's staying the night, not in the day. When it's coming dark, everybody think, okay, I don't go out because it's more dangerous now. It's more things, you know, walking there. But it's a lot of people there. When I come down, that's when I see many just start to come.
Yeah.
Many just go there to enjoy the night.
Before we continue, I want to say Ed sent us $13 on the Cash App. So thank you, Ed. And Nata can buy another cup, another caipirinha at another spot that she can show you. This is what it's all about, guys. Getting her to get out there and show you these spots. Next question. And I don't want to say the last name here, but I'm going to maybe assume that it's Ed Babin. I don't know. You tell me. Is it better to go during the day or night?
Yes. If you want to enjoy the view, I suggest to go in the day.
Mm-hmm.
Now in the evening, not when it's completely dark. If you want to enjoy the live music, you know, the vibes, then I suggest to go in the night.
I suggest you do what Hanata did. Go about half an hour before the sun sets, or an hour or half an hour before the sunset. Enjoy the sunset. Enjoy that view. You get the daytime view and you get the sunset. And that's a beautiful thing. Then you get the night and you get to enjoy dancing and
just go there like 5 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think that's
the thing is when you are there, you don't want to leave.
Yeah.
I've been in this place a couple times already. And when I'm there, I don't want to go. I just want to stay. But I have to leave. I have to. Oh, my God.
Here's a message. Rocinha tem tudo. E uma cidade.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, that's what I say. Rocinha is the big, it's the huge one. And Vidigal also, Vidigal have everything there. You know, you found everything in Vidigal. But Rocinha, oh my God, 10 times more big.
Chris has a question for you. He asked, Niterói Contemporary Art Museum, have you ever been to this place? It looks interesting.
In Niterói?
Yeah. The art museum there?
Yes, where's the guns? Where's the... Have the things for the fights? I don't know how to explain. Yes, I was there one time.
Okay.
Yes, inside, but just walking outside, looking around. Yes,
maybe that's a place you can go. I don't know what's in it. I don't know if it's really worth it, but maybe do some research and see if it's something that you think people would want to see. I'm not a museum guy myself. I'd rather be outside than just walking around looking at stuff inside. That's me. Okay, let's continue. Can I go alone or should I bring a friend? I think that goes with the safety as well, right? Is that something I can, if I'm by myself, just go by myself, or should I find somebody to go with?
Yeah, that's why I put these questions, because that's not mean if you are with somebody, if you are with your friend, you're safe. You know, it's safe anyway. If you go alone, if some things have to be happens, it go happens with you alone or not alone. So... No.
That's pretty dire. Okay.
But nothing is going to happen. So, of course, you are fine to go alone there. You can have fun also. But I'm sure if you have somebody, some friend come with you and enjoy the nighttime, the vibe, you have much more fun. I mean, when I go out alone by myself to the club, I don't have same fun when I go with my friend. You know, I just sit there, drink, and wait for see somebody that I know. Because, let's say, my friends, they are all busy, and I want to go out and enjoy the night. So I say, okay, they are busy. I go there by myself, and I make some friends there. Because, you know, I don't possibly enjoy myself be alone in a place to walk, dance, and have fun, you know. So,
yeah, you
can go there alone, but if you go with some friend, of course, you have much more fun.
Yeah, you're kind of gambling. Some people are like that, they like to go to places by themselves. Some people are very extroverted and they're confident they'll go out and meet people and be, you know, but it's a gamble because sometimes you meet people that are really friendly and you get along with and it's all good and you join another group of people or whatever, but you might as well just bring somebody or bring a couple of people. It's always more fun when you're around people that you know. Okay, that's all for the questions, man. That was, Kanata. I like the spot. I like the spot. I definitely got to get there, you know? That's a nice place. Yeah, Vidigal. Okay, does anybody have any questions for Renata? I do want to say that I know I was supposed to put up the video.
And put the link.
Oh, the link. Oh, yeah, okay. Okay, link. Here's the link for anybody that wants to come in. I'll put it up for Renata. She always wants me to put it up for her. Here's the link. I know I was supposed to get that video up with all the interviews, but it's been really crazy for me the last week. I had to go to Baltimore last weekend and shoot an event that I sponsored. Well, the company that I work for, we sponsored this event, and I had to shoot and edit a video for it. And I just got it completed, like, last night or this morning. So I will put up all the interview stuff by tomorrow morning. Sorry for that. Sometimes it just gets busy.
Somebody want to come to the room talking about the place we talked tonight?
Yeah, Charles is in the waiting room. He said, hold on, he sent a message. He said, queremos por você a praticar o seu português em aplicativo de idioma, duolingo, here we go. Charles, welcome to the room.
What's up, everyone?
Hey.
Boa noite, tudo bem?
Boa noite. I'm good. And you? How are you doing?
Still bem.
Good.
Okay. Yeah, so, I definitely got to add Vidigal to the itinerary.
You're not being a Vidigal yet?
No, just Rocinha.
Rocinha. And do you like Rocinha? Where do you go when you are there?
Yeah, I like it a lot. Just did the 3-hour tour. I started at the top, of course, worked my way down. Some of the best food I had was in Rocinha.
Yeah, you are in Mirante da Rocinha when you are there, or you are in any other place?
I didn't go inside any any particular place. It's just that restaurant. I can't remember the name of it. It was a churrascaria.
Yes. You're going to the churrascaria, the steakhouse, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, some tourists, you know, some they say they are in a favela. They walk in inside the house, talk with guys, you know, and they talk a lot of things.
Well, I take that back. I did go to the tour guide's house. But everything else, we just went on. I take that back. I also went to a church now that I remember. Otherwise, it was pretty much on the outside going through like the alleyways and stuff.
Yeah, that's what I want to ask. And you go into this entry in a small street, you go out from the main streets.
We went to the main streets and then we got on the bikes and just went all the way up and then we worked our way down.
Oh.
But you stayed on the main streets, though.
Yes.
But the other streets also in?
No, the only other streets we went to was by a market, by the tour guide's house. We went to a church over by, I think the area was like New Chicago.
Oh, and in Boston.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And then we went to that restaurant, and then we came back down. And then we went across the highway to... We went to a samba school, but they were those were during the time they were doing the vaccination, so we really didn't get to enjoy the school at all.
Mm. Yes, I asked them because some guys they say, you know, oh, I'm being there this place, and they take me, and I know the bus, and I know this, and I saw this, and I saw that, and I think, oh my god, okay.
Yeah, I'll show you pictures one day. I just got to find them and then upload them to you.
Cool.
Yes.
Yeah, you got to... It can be exciting going to these kind of places, but you just got to be aware. Be aware.
You know, I didn't see any hardware, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
I didn't see any of that. Any of the pharmaceutical company, the independent pharmaceutical... sales reps weren't around either, if you know what I mean.
Yeah. I see that you said Baltimore, what you said about Baltimore there. Oh, yeah, no. Baltimore, it can be, you know, yeah, even the we sponsored this competition. It was pretty cool. It was definitely a energetic vibe. It was different, but it's kind of exciting. But yeah, you got to just be aware and... Yeah, maybe I'll show that video. I have a 3-minute promo that I cut for Baltimore. I want to play that. That was fun. Just so people, because I know a couple of you guys have asked about me DJing, I guess, because you see the turntables back here and stuff.
Yeah, I didn't say anything about Baltimore. Someone else did. But yeah, every time I see the live stream, I can't help but look at your gear back there.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I'm kind of involved in the DJ community. I've done a lot of things in there and yeah, I'll show the video if you're good with that, Renata. Not right now, in a little while. We take some more questions and
yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, cool.
And you working now or you are home?
I'm at home chilling. I'm about to call it a night because I'm going to work early.
You're at home?
I'm at home.
You're never at home. You're always working.
I'm at home. This is a rare rare occurrence. But like I said, I'm about to call it a night. So not right now, but maybe in a few moments because I got to be up there early.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah, there's no background noise right now. So that's even better.
Yeah. You mean with me talking?
No, with me at work.
Oh, at work. Okay. All right, cool. Yeah, man. Well, stick around. If anybody else wants to come in, like I said, you're more than welcome. Any other questions for Renata regarding this favela or anything else?
You know, I got a question for you, Dennis. So when are you going to go down there and spend some tunes?
Yeah, I'm retired, man.
Nah, you got to come out of retirement just one time.
Yeah.
And you at Vidigal, spend some tunes, have Renata dancing with Stella and Ellie.
Yeah.
It'd be a good time.
Yeah, man, I don't know. I like to DJing is it's too much work, man. It's not that it's too much work. It's just a lot of extra stuff, preparing songs. Like, I mean, I used to tour all the time, and it's just something that I've kind of. I mean, like I said, I'm still involved in the community, but I don't tour anymore. I don't DJ anymore. But maybe one day I'll pull this up and before we go on a live, I'll do something. I don't know. Maybe.
That's cool.
Yeah. All right. Renata, there's a question here for... Oh, sorry, Charles. Oh, please. You good?
Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah, so when you plan to come, Charles?
I'm thinking about doing a quick trip, a very quick trip. Maybe in May. I haven't decided yet.
Oh my god.
Nice.
I'm still working out the logistics, but I'm thinking either May, possibly June. Just like a really quick trip.
Yes.
See,
in May it's come a lot of guys here in May.
Really?
I receive a lot of messages, the guys come. Two groups, they for two groups, one each group, one guy have a birthday, you know, and yes, and they have a couple ones, you know, not group but separate, not come with friends, they come in May. So in May it's a lot of tourists here.
Yeah, I'll definitely be down there solo. I don't know of any groups or anything like that.
Hold on, I want to make an announcement. Anthony.
Just a minute.
I don't know what just happened. Anthony, I'll announce it when she comes back. We got something from PayPal here. Okay, well, there's a couple more questions here. From MG, what is the difference between Rio de Janeiro and Niterói?
They're like neighborhoods.
Yeah, Niterói is, well, Rio de Janeiro is a state and Rio de Janeiro is a city. And Niterói is in Rio de Janeiro. It's just, Renata, there you are.
What?
What's the difference between Rio de Janeiro and Niterói?
The difference is... Rio de Janeiro, it's more like more houses. I think Niterói, it's the start for the beginning, where's the open area, you understand? Like Rio de Janeiro, it's many, many houses. You know, if you want to buy a house in Rio de Janeiro, and if you want more space, land, for your kids able to go up in a tree, run outside of the house. It's really hard, difficult. And Rio de Janeiro, it's so, you know, tight. And Niterói, some places in Niterói, it's very dangerous. So need to be careful when you guys come to Niterói side, especially São Gonçalo, you know, Niterói, have a special area where you can go for tourist areas, people's wears conditions. If you step out in a community, in a favela, then it's a problem. some favelas here, it's even more dangerous than Rio.
Good to know, guys.
Yes, but the difference is the Niterói, it's only other side of Rio. And that's where the area, it's more expensive. You understand? Expensive.
Expensive, yeah.
Not expensive. I mean, cash. But I mean, you found houses with area.
Houses with land.
Land, right. Because in Rio, it's very hard, difficult. Rio start to be small. You know, it's Rio, it's now it's tight, it's small with many houses, apartments, and a lot of things.
So there's Niterói, guys, across the bridge.
Yeah, if you check in Niterói, you can see the green area. And after to the bridge, you see a lot of green area. The green area, it's lands. So here, it's not same of Rio, you know. Have still a lot of rain, what's called?
A lot of land.
Land to buy, you know, to construction the house or to build one small house or something like that. And then it's not expensive. In Rio, it's more expensive than here from this side. So, but you can see more inside you come, more area that you have for spend.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah,
I live more inside, you know, like I live more like 1 hour and 30 minutes from Niterói, 40 minutes. I live very in, not from Niterói, but from Rio.
Yeah.
My house to Niterói, it's about 1 hour.
Okay. Here's another question. Renata, have you visited the U.S. before? Did you like it?
Yes, I really like it, and I really miss it. I miss my friends. I miss the place. I miss everything there.
Okay.
Yes. I have a lot of fun. I have a good time. It's really good.
Chris King wants to see you, Stella, and Ellie dancing. It's Estella, not Stella.
Oh, yes. Just go to the video where we're doing in Pedra do Sal.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Yeah.
Pedro have one video. It's me, Stella, and Ellie dancing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because now the girls, they are a little bit busy, you know. I talk to them almost every day. Today I talk with Lee. Yesterday I talk with Stella. You know, we talk all the time. We contact, but the girls, they work in. Lee, she makes some course. You know, she opened people's dying. She's working in Nicotere. You understand? When she need to open people's dying.
Oh, in a mortuary.
Found the reason why they dying and these things.
Autopsy. She's an autopsy technician.
Yeah, she's
or a coroner.
Mortician.
I think she's already finished, but now she's start to be another course. She's doing course to make woman stand with bikini mark.
Yeah, why do Brazilian women do those bikini marks? I've noticed that with every Brazilian woman, when they do tanning.
Yeah, because the women they like. You know, I do it a few times, I like, and that's also, it's very sexy, the guys, they like it.
Yeah.
They're asking for, so.
And that's actually becoming popular outside of Brazil. Brazil's the first time I ever saw that, but now I see it, like, in other places, they're doing the same thing. It's like they put tape, it's like tape, like the shape of a bikini, and then they get a really solid tan line, like, really contrast.
To me, it looks weird because I don't know if you ever seen the show King of the Hill, where they take their shirts off and they like have their tan arms and everything and then like their bodies.
What do they call that? The
farmer's tan.
Yeah, farmer's tan.
And I see that with like the Brazilian women with the bikini lines, and I'm like, okay,
it's a thing.
So the girls, they doing because they like it. And but it's now it's in the news. It's not allowed anymore because the light, it's a cancer, you know, it can get cancer.
Yeah, they do. They do that in on tanning beds.
Yeah, tanning beds are terrible.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they try to stop because it's not safe to do it. But the girls, they do it most of the time because the guys, they like to see it. Mm-hmm. They are for.
Okay, here's another question from MG is here. I don't hear Brazilians talking about bossa nova music. Is bossa nova music popular in Brazil?
Yes, but more for like it's many people from many age like the bossa music, you know. I have a bar before, I have a bar in restaurant, and I put bossa nova live music, and they close the street with, even I know asking for the government from the city, they close the street because I put in my restaurant the live music. It's a lot of busy, they close the street, they stay up there, drink, enjoy, eat, and everything, because most bossa music is very popular, but it's more for the oldies, you understand,
older people.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Better than Sertanejo.
Huh?
But I said it's better than Sertanejo.
Sertanejo, you really like Sertanejo, right?
I hate Sertanejo.
You hate? I think you like it because you talk about Sertanejo all the time.
No. Eu gosto de bossa nova, samba e pagode.
Oh, okay, that's good. Because a couple of times you come in live and you talk about Sertanejo, and I think, okay, so, nah. Okay.
I say no Sertanejo.
Cool. I don't like Sertanejo. It's a lot of suffer. You understand? Sertanejo, it's more for people, they suffer when they fall in love.
Like old school country music? They talk about their dog dying and their truck breaking down? And the love of their life.
Boho is like bluegrass or folk music.
Talk
like...
about it. You remember the plan that we made? To one house, two dogs, and two kids. And this and this and this and this and this. Oh my God.
Mm-hmm.
One of the most. But Brazil tricked us about 10 years ago. Because one of the most famous songs that came out around 2012. It's like, I forgot the name. It's like Mesa something Mata, whatever.
Santa Marta.
No, it's, I forgot his name, but I think it's like Michel Tello or something. I can't remember.
Michel Tello. Nossa, assim você me mata.
That
ai,
one.
Se eu te pego. Ai,
that
se
one.
Eu te pego. This one?
Yeah. Turns out that's a Sertanejo song.
Mm-hmm.
And Brazil tricked us. They tricked us big time with that song.
Yeah, this song is very popular.
It's extremely popular.
Brazil.
In fact, it was actually popular here for a while, too, in the States.
Yes.
Because they played it on the top
in
40.
Mexico, in yes.
Yeah, they played on the world. They played on top 40, and I think some of the Latin stations, too. Like, but it was everywhere.
Yes.
Okay. Chris King asks, is the currency in Brazil about to change? Have they announced anything on it? I still haven't seen this in the news. So I'm wondering if it's even, I don't know if it's real. Renata, do you know anything about the currency changing?
No. It's a long time I don't change a dollar. No, I don't remember.
You haven't heard anything about Brazil doing some type of deal with Russia and China to and no, nothing? Okay.
No.
Okay. All right, Marcus. Is this the same Marcus we know from Copa? Or you don't know yet? Marcus, do we know you? Is it the same Marcus, Renata?
No. Before, I think it's the Marks that I'm doing the tour.
Oh, okay, okay.
The guy, the YouTuber.
Oh, okay, okay, okay.
Yes, yes.
All right. All right.
And but it's not him. He's starting a new job tonight. So he says, sorry, I can't watch the live tonight because it's my new job. Yes, he's have a new job.
Wait a minute. Marcus is saying something. Eliama Sertanejo?
Yeah, he says he loves you. He's talking about you. You love that music.
Hey, Marcus, shut your ass up.
Okay. I don't know who Jorge and Mateus is, but I guess, yeah. Singers. Okay. Any other questions? Anybody else want to come in? I want to play my video. We got to continue these talks about the doing an event. Maybe next year around Carnival, doing some type of event. I'd love to bring maybe bring some DJs down from the US or something.
And you're going to DJ too, right?
No, I'm just
going right to
at the bar with a drink in my hand.
Right.
Bring
your hard drive.
MG is here, says, Dennis, do you get a chance to speak Portuguese every day? How is your learning coming along? I take a class 3 times a week. And I've just hit a point now. Like, I had to learn all these rules and basically rules on the language. And now I'm starting to actually speak. Like, I'm getting into the conversation, actually starting my next class. So, yeah, it's coming along. It's weird the way this teacher teaches me. It's cool, but she swears by it. And so now the speaking begins. That's why I say give me about a month or two and I should be pretty good. Yes, do an event. Yes. Okay, let me show my little 3-minute video. I shot this thing, I edited it. That's what I've been working on the last week that kept me from getting this other stuff done. Let me just show it just so people get an idea of what I do. Do you mind, Hinata?
Yes, it's good. Go ahead.
Hey, man. Great Glenn battle. Best Glenn battle.
One last time, I need y'all to roll. What the hell are you waiting for?
Shout out Virtual DJ.
You made me do. Look what I made for you. When you drop a couple of hits, look how they wait to
you. Yo, Virtual DJ always first. Always first. Always.
Hold on.
Biggest battle ever.
It was a great night. It was an absolute great evening.
Yep.
The Glenn battle, extra crazy.
One more round!
Make some noise for Virtual DJ one time. One of them big sponsors.
Bad bitch in jail, she was whoa. Had me fucked up in the head, I mean whoa. Bought the bitch diamonds and pearls, I mean whoa. Should've seen them shit shining on the wrist whoa. Now money ain't a problem, see my dough is like whoa. Pulled out my bankroll on y'all niggas like
I love the energy in the room. This is a goddamn battle, y'all.
Y'all battling! This is a fight. That is not your friend, and he is not your man.
I need both of y'all to act like y'all want this money.
I'm gonna add another 500.
Oh my God.
3,500.
Let's make it 4,000, goddammit.
Nitro, Mike Flow, nice clothes, like whoa. Beast paint with cocaine, like whoa. Now Doc Strange in the range, like whoa. 100 miles an hour switching lanes, like whoa.
Make some motherfucking noise for the Baltimore Blend Battle number 7 winner, D. J.T. 9!
The Glenn battle, extra crazy. A lot of money went down.
it just happened.
Yeah.
And y'all gonna talk about this for a little while. So all you DJs that did not participate, you need to get in the next one. Salute.
Great blend battle. Shout out to Virtue DJ.
Man, y'all seen how it went down. It's crazy. South Jersey's own T-Nice in the building, man. Salute. Big ups to Virtue DJ, to all the sponsors that came out tonight.
Anything all day championship for my man T-Nice. YDJ, salute you too.
Yes, sir.
I lost my voice. Listen, it was a show. That's all I'm gonna say. It was a show.
Bada bing.
Good.
Thank you, thank you.
I wish we were there. Shake, yes. shake booty.
Barracuda with the $2 super chat. Thank you, sir. Are you coming in the room? Let me throw up this link for Hinata again.
But just so we don't get it twisted, people, what does that say?
Good to see you.
Why do you have a shirt? Right?
Good to see you.
Why?
Because he's standing on the camera.
No, I'm talking about the shirt.
Oh, the shirt. I think I talk about him. Good to see him.
Look at the shirt.
Oh, sertanejo.
Why do you have a shirt? What? You're passionate about it, huh?
No sertanejo.
I know.
Hashtag no sertanejo. Why? Oh my god. You made the t-shirt you asking for?
Yeah, one of my friends in town, he has a t-shirt company, and I just asked him to make it for me.
Yes.
So me and my friend who lives in Salvador, she has one too. So there's only two of these that are made.
Oh.
I can get you one door.
There are good songs. They are good music.
I'm sure there is. But overall, it's no such an Asia.
My friend, he's remind me today. I talked with him early or last night. I tried to remember. He say, Renata, remember the t-shirt. I need to pee.
Oh my goodness. Chris says, imagine this event in the favela. Yeah, I'm saying, Chris, I've done promotions in the past. I have people that do promotions. I have DJs in Brazil as well on lock. So when we do, I know Renata and I, we've spoken about it a lot before. When we do something, it's going to be big. So, and it'll be promoted well. So be prepared for that.
But I like the t-shirt.
Yeah, I'm gonna.
I do not agree completely because have some sertanejo music. It's good.
Shouldn't it say now? Sing sertanejo.
No, it's supposed to say no sertanejo.
Yeah, it say não sertanejo. Hashtag não sertanejo.
Yeah.
But I'll get you one, Hinata. Just send me a message on Instagram with your size, and I'll have one made for you.
Oh, thank
you. Why, you hate it too, Renata?
She doesn't hate it. It's just, she said there's some good songs. Which, I mean, truth be told, every genre does have good music. Don't get me wrong, but overall, I'm just not a fan of the genre. And the shirt lets you know.
Okay. Yeah.
All right, let me pull the screen out.
But I know I couldn't wear this outside of Rio.
Yes. That's but crazy. my size, it's a P medium. I don't know.
Small.
Yeah, small and medium.
No, small. American size, you're going to be extra small.
When, yes, yes. When I live in the United States, I need to go to the kids area to buy clothes for me.
That's what I'm saying. You're not no medium.
I remember. Yes, I can't believe even the kids' clothes, some, you know, shorts, jeans, it's big.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yep. Okay, we're at an hour and a half. Anybody want to come in and ask any questions?
What is that?
This is a local beer.
That's beer?
That's beer.
Is it? It's flavor. It says milk on it. Imperial milk stout?
Huh? Oh,
it's a milk stout.
Beer and milk?
A stout. Yeah, there's that's a thing. We do that in Jamaica too. We take Guinness and we mix it with sweet milk and oats and all kind of stuff.
I can't. No way.
Yeah.
Milk and beer?
It's not milk and beer. It's brewed from it. It's a stout, like a Guinness.
Yeah. Like if you get a, you know what Guinness is, right? You've had Guinness before, that really dark beer?
Yeah, the dark beer, I know.
In Jamaica, we take that and we mix it with sweet milk and like sometimes they put oats in it and other things in it, and they make a, like a, it's a drink. It tastes really good.
Yeah, but this one have what inside, and then it's exactly taste what?
What does it taste like? I don't know.
I'm trying to get the description in the camera.
What color is it?
Oh, it's dark brown.
Yeah.
So maybe it's this kind of
dragon style, yeah.
Dark and beer, dark.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Next time you got to pour it out so she can see it.
Bring one. With
hazelnut. Yeah.
Put in your pocket and bring it to me. No, I'm joking.
No, I'll bring you. I'll bring you some.
It's not allowed. I don't think.
Yeah, so. It is. I can bring it.
Drink.
Yeah, I'll bring you a six pack.
Bring a six pack in your.
List. And Mountain Dew also, because I love Mountain Dew. Oh boy!
Yeah, I didn't.
So bring Mountain Dew, and we have some caipirinha that I make with Mountain Dew.
You think it's safe to bring that in your luggage?
Yeah.
On the plane with the pressure and stuff.
Yep.
Yeah.
I've done it before. And I brought back beer from Brazil here. So.
Wow. Okay. That's different.
Wow, good.
I can't get Brahma in the States, so I got to get a six pack of Brahma and put it in my cooler and just put it in my check luggage.
You got to look for the Brazilian store.
Oh boy, you take Brahmas there?
Mm-hmm. I brought some back from Rio. And bottles in certain brands of cachaça.
It's not.
I can bring it.
No, okay. The cachaça, it's okay. You know,
beer too.
Yes, but okay. The can, I don't know. Mm-hmm. I know the glass, it's fine. It's fine, but I don't know the can.
You can bring the can. Right? You can bring the cans.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Not really. Just put in your check luggage. Make sure it's packed securely so the can doesn't burst. And if customs ask you anything,
you check that in, and then you might get the biggest surprise of your life when you go get your luggage on the belt and it's leaking.
Yeah, that's if you don't know how to pack it.
Oh boy!
Yeah.
Trust me, because that happened to my friend. She brought me. She tried to bring me a can of beer, and it, you know, it punctured.
Yeah. Yes, that's because this can, it's not hard, it's not safe, it's very easy, you know.
Yeah, that's why you got to know how to pack it. If you know how to pack it and wrap it, you'll have no problems.
Okay.
All
right.
And also, I packed a cooler, so
nice.
Okay, so any other questions? Anybody else want to come in the room? We've passed our hour and a half, and we're going to shut it down soon. Yeah, and not to anything else that you wanted to cover before we head off? Anything?
Huh?
What's the next video gonna be about next week?
Yes, Santa Teresa.
Santa Teresa.
You hear about it, Charlie, before? Dennis, no. I think so.
Yeah, no. I've seen pictures.
No, never. Yes,
Santa Teresa, it's one old place and downtown. There they have many hostels. You know hostel?
Yeah, staying in one. I stayed at the Mango Tree in Ipanema. It's a great hostel.
Yeah, it's like behind Lapa, behind the Celeron stairs. That area, it's like it looks. I saw it in a picture, and I'm like, this isn't real. It looks like San Francisco, or it's got those what are those cars called?
With the trolleys.
Yeah. Got the trolleys running through there, and the houses look like some classic house. It's different. It looks.
Yes, like I wanted to do something even more because, you know, to me, you know, I want to show you guys the place, you know, because some tourists already stay there and they like it. They say it's good, it's okay, but I don't see nothing like interesting here. I want to show in this day, Monday, in this video, another thing for you can guys go and enjoy. You understand? Because this video to me, it's a little bit slow because I was in a train, go inside the city, show all the trip. It's nice, the house, but it's not have nothing like important, some activity for you guys just go and do it. I walk into the Mirante to show the nice view, the fantastic view. And the Mirante, it's not like something I can see and then say, oh my God, look that, you know?
So what did you do there? Just walk around? Did you find anything?
No, nothing. Just walk and show old houses. And that's it.
Well, you better go do another short video so that we have some nice to show.
So I think, yes, when you ask me what we show in Monday, and I think, oh my God.
Okay, question. That train that goes across Lapa,
did you get on that? This train is good. This train I recommend. You know, you sit there if you want to know Santa Teresa. Just sit in the train, get the train. I show how to do it, where you're going to take the train. The history have some museum there, the small one, because the big one, it's get fired. It's, you know, and they have one provisory now with the train station, where to get the train. And I explained how to go there. Where's the place exactly, how much it's cost, because before they say it's only cost cents corners to go there, take the train, but it's not true. It costs 20 real the ticket, and you just go in a train all the way up. You pass to this Arco da Lapa, you know Arco da Lapa? Arc, this thing, the white thing.
Arco da Lapa, yeah.
What is called?
Arc. When you go into Lapa, you're going under this bridge, and it's like these white arcs, and it's
the train, it's a rail. Train rail. The station, it's there in the beginning for there. And then it's past in the top this arc and go inside the city, this place where it's called Santa Teresa. So
there's the arc right there behind us.
I've been there before, have nice restaurants, nice bars.
There's the arc.
Where? I don't see. No, I just see some wow.
This is the arc. You remember when we were in after Celeron stairs?
Yeah. There.
Yeah, that's the arc.
A little bit. Yeah. So this thing, it's passing the top there. And then it's really good when it's passing the top there. In the back, I don't have no more charge in the camera, but in the back, I have some small adventure by myself. It's bad I not record, but I just put my hands up and I go, ah! because the train to go up, it's go slow. It's okay, you know? But when it's come down, oh my God, then I feel the vibe. Oh boy. I just go, ah! And everybody in the train, okay. Yeah, it's good, very good.
Okay.
I recommend to take the train and get known the place.
All right. Okay. All right. Well, let's, I guess, wrap it up. Any more questions? Charles, anything else you want to say?
When I'm there, it's a lot of tourists there.
You said you went on a Monday.
Huh?
You went on a Monday?
No, I was there yesterday.
Oh, okay. A lot of tourists there?
A lot of tourists there. When I walk in, I see and I hear they don't speak Portuguese. They are from other places.
Okay. Well, that's great. Chris King says you're doing a great job, Renata.
Thank you. Thank you.
And thank Bianca for me again, because I never see her, but...
Yeah, she's watching.
She's doing a good job.
Yes.
Okay.
Actually, in your 3-minute video, I heard one of my favorite songs in there.
Which one?
Old school song.
Which one?
The System, Don't Disturb This Groove.
Oh. And you know why I put that in there? Because I love that song, but this whole DJ event was about blending music, right? They take acapellas and they mash it up with different instrumentals and stuff, and what that DJ did with that song was wicked. Like, he just, you know, and then that nostalgia, to hear that in a club, you would think most people would be like, oh, that's a corny old music, but that's what they're about. They're about taking old school vibes, you know, like rare grooves and R&B and mashing it up with hip-hop and all that. See, 90s, 80s, 90s.
I think old school music would definitely work well in Brazil. It's just
because
I remember when I was down there for the Super Bowl last year, and they had like Dre, Snoop, Eminem, 50 Cent. The place I was at went wild.
Definitely, when you go, when you hear hip hop, if you go to a club and they're playing hip hop, they're playing old school stuff, and they do a lot of like remixing, like they'll mash it up with some of the Brazilian funky music.
Right.
We do a lot of that too. Some people don't like that. I think it's great. Like, you're reviving old school stuff and getting younger people to know some of the older music by doing all these different remixes. It's cool.
Yeah, I'm personally not a fan of funky, but if it introduces them to hip hop, then I'm all for it.
Yeah. I was, you know, when you become a fan of funky, when you're in the club and you see all the girls dancing to it.
Of course.
Then you're like, yeah. Yeah, get it.
If I see like Hanata dancing to Funky or someone like that, or her seller, yeah, I'd be a number one fan right there.
Okay.
Oh. Yeah, just wait for you to come, and then we go out and dance in some fun.
You'll dance, I'll watch, because I can't dance to save my life.
Okay, you watching, I'm dancing and record.
Uh-oh.
No?
No, that's fine. It's all right. It's all good.
Yeah, just small parts.
Yeah, mm-hmm. She says small parts, but I'll be featured in the next video.
All right.
No, it's all good. I'm down, Hanata.
Yeah.
Hold on. Black Fist 86, what do you know about 90s R&B, Dennis? You listen to Lou Rawls? Yeah, I know about Lou Rawls. Yeah, man. That's not 90s. That's like early 80s, 70s.
Now Lou Rawls is well before that.
That's not 90s, man.
Lou Rawls is well before then.
Yeah, man. Lou Rawls is like late 70s, early 80s. But you'll never find. I forget the name of the song, but yeah, man. He was the man back in the day.
What's the song, Dennis?
Huh?
What's the song?
I think it's called You. I'm not going to pull it up now. But yeah, I know that song well because I used to mash up, like when I used to play my DJ sets, I used to put some of the old school stuff in my mixes. And that's one of the songs I would put in sometimes. So, yeah. Yeah. Okay. So we've come
before
to
the end. Before we go, I'm going to send Hanata the track.
Okay. Yeah? What?
Hold on, Hanata.
I'll send you the track, the song.
The song I was talking about in Dennis's video. I just sent it to you.
I understand, Dennis. It's better not try. No, it's okay. I understand. I know the song already.
Oh, that other song that he's talking about from the thing. You know that song because I like, yeah, you know, everybody knows that song. Come on.
Not everyone.
Yeah. Yeah, I used to mash up some Barry White too. You'd be surprised. I mean, I've been in the, like, my thing was I used to just try to shock the audience, right? I'd be in front of on stage at a festival in Australia and drop or New Zealand and drop Barry White and see the crowd go crazy. I have videos of that. You can see it online. Yeah.
I gotta get to New Zealand. I have a friend who lives in Auckland, so and she's on my ass about coming down there, so
yeah. All right. Okay, let's shut her down, man. That's it. Charles, thank you, sir. It's been
a
pleasure. And Renata. Thank you everyone for coming out and supporting. Thanks for the super chats, the Cash App, the PayPal, much appreciated. It keeps Hanata out there working. And make sure you come out to the Monday show. That's 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Hanata is going to show us the area called
Santa Teresa.
That's going to be the next show. And I'm sure she's going to get something else because she says it.
Yes, yes, definitely.
Okay. So we'll see you on Monday and have a great weekend, Hanata.
Thank you, guys. I hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to like, subscribe, follow me on Instagram, subscribe to the channel, and see you guys the next live. Kisses. Okay. Thank you, Charlie, for participating in life. I really love it. I appreciate it.
Muito obrigado para tudo. Quais as que você faz?
Huh?
Muito obrigado pelo tudo. Quais as você faz?
Oh, you're welcome. I appreciate it. I really love what you guys comment, what you guys like it, you know, you guys send message and say like the contents, the videos and everything, the info. It's made me very happy all the time when I see these messages, people appreciate and like everything. It's make me more motivate, more want to go out and show more and more.
Okay.
Thank Sounds you guys. Good.
All right, guys.
Good night, guys. Next slide. How done?
Peace.
Peace.